Hello everyone, FunchonX here. Welcome to my Let's Play of Space Engineers on Planets, Episode 4. Hope you guys liked the time-lapse of the garage. If you didn't see it, it's over there. It's done, except for probably a blast door and maybe some doors here. I'm not sure how I want to make that. I actually have never made a blast door, so that will be a new experience, but I'll put it in this opening here. But I've verified everything works. This guy will connect to the connector. It can pass stuff through. And then I've got a few conveyor systems. Stop crouching. To pass stuff through the wall. And then it's going to come out here. And then we'll have some tube networks that will go all over our base so everything connects. So that's the garage. That's my first attempt at a non-box building. I gave it a little bit of slope and some windows. And I think it turned out well. I even painted some things. So I'm going to try and keep the walking area gray. That'll be my paint scheme, and I don't plan to make the entire base yellow. Most of the garage will be, well, all of the garage pretty much is, and then the other sections of the base will just have, like, you know, highlights of yellow. Okay, for this episode, the sun is about to go down, so I think I'm gonna do a little bit of building. I've got this area laid out here, and then as soon as the sun comes back up, we will go out driving again in our car looking for some more ores. We really need some iron. And I want to explore over that direction. So we'll take a look over on these hills and see what we can find. For now, here's what we want to do. We want to lay out some refineries, some arc furnaces, and some assemblers in this room here. What I'm thinking is if we have, let's see, refineries are pretty big. They're 2x2x4, but then you also have the add-ons in the back, so technically they're 3x2. So if I put them like right, if that's, this line is the wall right here, I have to put it all the way up here, which I think is too close. So I'm going to back it up all the way here and I'll put more room in the back. So I'm working on an odd build scheme here. So I've got two hallways that are going to come into this room, one where that assembler is now and one where it's going to open right there. So if I put one here, that's not going to line up. So I think I have to put one here and here, so we'll have to do it mirrored. Is this right side up? It looks to be. So one there and one there. Okay, looks good. Now we also want our arc furnaces, and I think I might do a total of 4 refineries, so we can put another one down. We don't have to weld it, right? We can just kind of lay it out. So refinery, will you go down without me having blocks there? No, you will not. Okay. Come on. Come on. Why won't you place? It's not giving me any error message. What's going on? Do I have any steel plates? Inventory. Yeah, 100 steel plates. Have we crashed? can I put something else down? Oh, okay, I can put that down. Maybe it's just a... Okay. Just some weird glitch for a second there. Whatever. So the other refinery. Need to twist you around again. Come on. Where are you? I'm having trouble placing stuff right now. There we go. All right, so those will be our 4 refineries. I think 4 will be enough. I don't plan to have a huge influx of ore anytime soon, at least. If we get more, then maybe we'll put more on the behind it, so we'll have like a hallway here to go through. Okay, so we need to hook those up to our conveyor network, and we also need to obviously weld them. I'll weld them a little bit later. So those will be our 4 refiners. We also need some arc furnaces. How big do we want to get this room here? Let's do those. You guys know me, I'm gonna be all about symmetry. Oh, can I sneak this under there? Come on, there we go. How are we gonna fit those? I was thinking as far as the assembler goes, if I do that, shift two, if I put my assemblers right, let's see. Yeah, right up against that? That would be fine. I can put two upgrades on either side and still leave the hallway. Or an upgrade on either side. And the hallways will be clear, and I can stack these up. And I think I want to go with three of them that'll be like my on-demand ad hoc crafting, so if I just need something. And then I'll have another bay that'll be the auto-crafting setup that I already had in my previous season. So I think that's a good place for the assemblers. We'll just make one for now, but again, we'll stack them up and we'll put upgrades here. So now, yeah, I just need to find a place for the blast furnace or the arc furnaces. We're probably not going to have any more hallways going there because the solar farm's there, so we could just line them up right along this wall here. So are we going to need... That's our opening. So I think our wall, our actual wall, will be here. Something like this. Come on. You know, I was thinking I could save a lot of material if I built my floor out of, like, sloped blocks instead. Because, you know, they would look the same from the top. You couldn't tell the difference, right? But they take 13 steel plates instead of 25. So I might do that in here just to conserve on steel plates. All right, and then our wall is going to be right here. Yeah, I'm going to just keep it as very boxy right now, and I'll add accents and decoration later. All right, so that's going to be the corner of our room. So we're going to have a conveyor network come out of there, probably run along the ceiling. So let's see what a blast furnace has as far as connections. Do we have one up top? Or is it only on the bottom? I mean, technically, I could put them upside down. Or I could run the conveyor behind it. Yeah, you're upside down, right? Yeah. So what if we... Where's the actual word that says blast furnace? Right there. Yeah, so we're going to have to run something behind it. So let's keep them out from the wall by one. That's fine. And let's do them right here. We'll do one, two, three. Nickel, iron, and cobalt. Okay. Not going to be symmetric. We're going against the grain here. That's okay. And then, yeah, we'll have our finish off our wall over here. And we'll have some kind of hallway. Let's see, where's the middle of this room? Let's see, we want to have, again, some space for the conveyor right there. So this will be our door. Oops. Let's do some counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So our block door will be at 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Door right here. All right, and that'll be our door going into whatever room we build next. Wow, we're gonna need a lot of steel plates. I thought those 9,000 steel plates we started with would get us pretty far, but they're dwindling down. I think we're down to 3,000. I'm about to use them all up on those refineries. Although I'm not gonna weld everything, but let's see what we've got here. So yeah, let's start with steel plates. Just take as many as we can. And yeah, let's just activate one here that we know will be against the conveyor belt. Man, even on like... full mode welding. These things take forever to weld. All right, we need some steel plates, large tubes, motors. Okay. Steel plates. Large tubes. Motors. What was the other thing? I don't remember. Somebody told me I could break down the tools. Can I? Let's see. Disassembling tools. I can. Wow. Okay. Let's do that. So disassemble all the grinders. Is it working? Is it doing anything? Not enough power. Okay, so apparently all my battery power, because it is now night, this is completely drained into my car, maybe? Or is the battery just dead just from... Yeah, I'm not connected there. So where did my battery go? I thought it would last a lot longer than this. Control panel. Battery. Stored power. It's not outputting anything. Why not? Discharge. Interesting. Well, okay. I really don't know. Maybe it worked. Did it start working? Get rid of all the grinders. So technically you just kill yourself over and over again and you'd be fine. I don't know why the battery isn't outputting power to that. That doesn't make any sense. I mean, it's making a sound like it's doing something. All right, so refinery online. There we go. And let's go ahead and bring this guy online as well. Come on, steel plates. You take forever. Okay. So now we can go ahead and cancel that. Take everything out of the assembler. Because we're about to get rid of it. Okay, so the assembler is empty, so we're free to grind away. And we should have plenty of room to hold that all in our inventory, because we are super backpack mode. And let's get that welded up. All right, assembler complete. Now let's get one arc furnace online, so we'll just go ahead and go with this guy. Oh. Construction component, large steel tube, motor computer. Okay, we can do that. Motor computer, large steel tube. There we go. Nope, don't sneak. Okay, that guy's done. Online. Sweet. Now we're just left with connectors. So that one will connect to you fine. And I would like to be able to walk through this. So I don't think we're actually going to connect those two. Instead, let's run them right down here. So we definitely got to hit those. So we'll just go ahead and turn it straight down like this. Yep. And then straight, number six, bam, bam, bam. And on these ones, we want to have actual conveyors because we've got to have them going in and going straight. So one. Interior plates. Oh, come on. Three. Back to the straight ones. Okay, so that should connect the refinery with the arc blast furnaces. Now from there, we've got to connect to that one and this. And let's see, we're stacking these up, right? I need to get up there. Give me one of these just to get up. Yeah, so these are going to be stacked. So let's just go with a conveyor right here. Or do we want to do it through the bottom? Eventually, I would like to make this thing airtight, but I don't know how I'm going to do that. Well, we should be fine because we've got that whole perimeter. Yeah, this should be fine. Okay, so we're going to take this block out here. Grinder, please. And we're going to put a conveyor right in there. So that will connect our cargo container, which right now is small, but maybe we'll make large later or something. That'll connect it with the assembler. Now we just need to get from here across. So we're going to go straight up. And I'll need a ramp of some sort to get up to here. Oh, no, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, well. How am I going to get up? Fine. Nope. Go away. All right, we need one here. There we go. That'll let us get up just for temporary. And at this point, we'll bend it and send it straight across. Nice that I can see. Okay, that's right. Perfect. It was already aligned. So it'd be cool. We'll be able to see like the tube on our roof. I like visible pipes, you know, just to kind of be able to see. We're gonna be able to see that. Oh, come on. Get there. Yep, got it. And come on, hit that. Go. Yep. And you... Oh, not close enough. Ah, switch to... Stop doing that. And this was only temporary, so I can get rid of it. And this one will come up. There we go. So now our garage is connected to our cargo container, is connected to our arc furnace. Now we just have to get it over to there. So I think for that, we'll go... Which way do I want to go to get that way? Let's get back up here. I had to think what would look good and what's practical, right? Can I get up on there, please? I'm going to switch this block here to make it a conveyor so it's an intersection. And then we'll head with a... Tricky. Because that's going to be stacked tall. But I want to get over there. I don't know how I'm going to do this. I know what I'll do. I can come out of one of the front of the assemblers. So for right now, I won't worry about it. But later, I'll add something. When I stack the assemblers higher, we'll do this. So this will come to the middle of the room, which is right here. One more. And then have a conveyor. And then it'll come out this way. And you are the middle. Yes. I don't know, it's using a lot of conveyors, but that's okay. I think we'll be all right. So we need, what, one more straight guy, then a bent curvy guy, which I can't reach. Let's go behind it. See if we can reach from here. Probably not, actually. Jump, dude. My guy sucks at jumping. All right. So, 7. Curve down. Straight. Into there. Okay, that should connect everything. Now we gotta weld it all up. So, let's time-lapse mode here. Go. And hopefully we have enough materials. And I don't know if I will or not, but we'll be back in a little bit. We'll be right back. All right, guys, we're back from the time lapse. Hope you enjoyed. We got everything connected and it looks to be automatically processing what we needed to. We don't have any ores that work in the blast furnace, so that guy's not online, but this refinery is now processing our nickel and our uranium. Pulling out like 600 megawatts, which is about what we draw during the day. So we can't run that for too long, but everything is connected. We use just about every single component we had in our base, but now we can just pull this guy in and the ores will be sucked out and put in a refinery. Awesome. I love once everything is just automated and pulling and that kind of stuff. So it is daytime. Let's go driving around and look for stuff. I need to do one thing that I keep forgetting to do, and that's add a GPS coordinate to my base so I remember I can figure out how to get back. So let's just kind of put us right in the center here. Hit K, GPS, new, and we'll name this one Funshine X Base. I will call it the Earth Base just in case we need to get back to it from another planet. Okay, so we can leave that one on the HUD. Let's go get in our car and take it for a spin. As always, before I go on a spin, I'm going to save it. we'll save this as base automated. So if I need to come back to that point, I will know it. All right, here we go. Time to drive. Parking brake off. We're disconnected already from our thing. A lot of people, based on what I've been reading in the comments of my videos and also just personal experience, is that one of the main things that flips your car or makes it bounce a lot is the max speed. So if we look at our wheels, speed limit, I've got it set to 76 because our friction's pretty high. It's at 50%, but whenever you bounce, those wheels lose contact with the ground. That's not good. we just fell through the world. What I was going to try to say is when you bounce, you get zero friction because your wheels aren't contacting the ink, and so they immediately speed up to their max speed, and if you have that set to 100 or 200 or unlimited, they go super fast, and then when they land again, they jolt forward and then bounce again, and then it's just a constant cycle. So setting your max speed down to something around 60-70 is very important. All right, I guess we're just going to have to load back up that save. That's one of the reasons I do the saves, but we look and we can see Mars over there. That's kind of nice. And that must be the alien planet there. Cool. Beautiful. We're just falling and falling and falling. All right, let's load it up again. Okay, guys, I'm back. I am about to take the car out again for a spin. That bug where I fall into the ice has happened to me 3 times. That's the first time I've got it on camera, so I can go hopefully log it as a bug to the developers. See if they can fix it. I'm not sure if it only happens on ice. To me, it personally has only happened on ice, but it's very annoying. One thing I want to do is if I'm out and I flip, I always want to have enough stuff to build a thruster, one of these small atmospheric thrusters. So you can see those take, on a small ship, 2 construction components, 18 motors, a metal grid, a large steel, large steel tube, and some steel plates. All right, let's see if we have that. Got those. We need some metal grids, large steel tubes, and what else? motor, large metal steel motors. Okay, need a lot of motors. So that should be enough now to build a thruster. If I ever do flip, I can put it on the side and try and use it to flip the machine. Yeah, okay, good. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it on my ship just so I don't have to carry the materials around. And then if I ever ever do flip, I'm just going to grind it down and then use it to flip me over. So it's going to be like tow package. Where do I want to stick this thing? We got some room right here. Oh, yeah, that'll be good. Right there. Can I move it over one? All right, it's going to have to be there. So get there, weld the thing up. Now I can put this stuff. I also want to make sure I always have steel plates on me so I can build ramps and that kind of thing. But all this stuff can go away. Let's be down to 160. And we're ready to take it out for another spin. I definitely want to make sure I find this thruster. Where are you? And we'll call it flipper. We'll call it the flipper and we'll turn it off. Oh, wait. I want to rename it flipper. How do I rename the thing? There. Flipper is off. Perfect. Auto brake off. And let's go. Now let's head down the opposite direction on the ice. We're going to go over this way. Are you serious? Are you serious? Just randomly been driving fine for a long time, and all of a sudden it's just like, nope, I'm going to bounce high in the air for no particular reason. Gotta love the physics. And we fell through the world again. Okay, so apparently I need to mark that spot. There is a hole in the world. Awesome. Be right back. All right, guys, we are back. So I think that bug just has to do, there's some kind of world hole that it's, you know, it's painting with ice, but there's no actual stuff there. So I got to be watch out when I drive this direction from my base. But I've made it around it. I just took a nice wide path. And we're almost to a little area. I can see some darkness there on the mountain. So we might have some ore there. Let's zoom out and see if we can see it. Oh, we got another one over there. Looks like we got two patches. Let's check out the ice ones first. They seem to be easier to dig into. And I don't have to drive up the mountain to get to it. Let's not flip. Come on. Come on, little car. There we go. All right. So let's check out this one first. Stay at a nice 77 kilometers an hour. If we go 88, we're going to go into space. I mean, into the past or the future or something. I did not turn. Why did you all of a sudden take a right turn there? There's just random bumps in this ice. Like, when this lake froze, it must have been really windy that day. All right, let's the big reveal. What do we have underneath the surface? We have gold. Sweet. Can make some thrusters. I think thrusters take gold. Lots of gold. Look at all this gold. Okay, what do we got around here? Let's keep following it. Oh, that's the end of that one. So that whole, like, T is all gold, or I guess it's more of a C here. Now what's over in the middle? Ice, and more ice, and gold. Wow, this gold vein. Oh, it's silver, okay. What do we use silver for? I don't remember what silver is used for very much. That's okay. Silver, and does it extend this whole thing? And there's like nothing out here. What is out here? Nothing? Okay, well this is gold and silver, so let's go ahead and mark that on our communicator here. So GPS, new from current. And we'll change this to gold. Oh, silver and gold. It's our favorite. Silver and gold. Silver and gold. All right, parking brake off. And let's go check out the one that is up on the hill. Because silver and gold's nice, but I don't really need it. I need iron, nickel, cobalt. That was my biggest need at the moment, because the materials I got from tearing down that ship are not going to last forever. I'm tempted to, like, save again, like, every, like, 2 minutes, just save this stupid game in case I fall into the world hole, flip over my ship or something. He's just, like, driving to the right for no reason. Like, he's going straight, and he's like, no, I want to go over to the right. I'm just going to take a right turn. I need to get an alignment. Where's the Jiffy Lube around here? Come on. All right, let's slowly make our way over to this hill. That better be an ore. That would be nice, having a third pocket of something really close. What are you? What are you? Come on, be something good. It's funny, you just look around and it doesn't seem like the world is that big, but then once you drive, you're like, oh my gosh, this takes forever. We definitely want to get a flying ship sooner than later so we can get a little better scouting. And we also want an automated ore miner. I haven't decided what I want to do for that yet. All right, what do we have? We have magnesium. Okay, does that mean you're going to be paired with uranium again? Because like you were last time? This is all magnesium. Okay. Not too happy or thrilled about that. And more magnesium. Oh, it's hard to see when... Oh, silicon. More silicon. Okay, so it looks like the nodes, if you get magnesium, you're going to get silicon and uranium as well. That just seems like all three of them happen to go together, because I've got uranium behind me, silicon underneath. Whoa, we just caught air. Silicon underneath me and magnesium back there. All right, well, let's take a spin. I'm going to save again. This will go as car scouting. Car or scouting. Oh, is it becoming night? Or the shadows just randomly coming? Looks like it is becoming night. I love the that the planet is right there aligned with the sun, that we get that eclipse every single night. That's pretty cool. But that does mean the planets are not moving, obviously. They're all stationary. The sun kind of goes around them. That's okay. The planets don't rotate. The sun goes around the planets. They're fixed in space. It's okay. All good. Cool. Well, I think we're going to call it here. I did find two more patches of ore. Not exactly what I was looking for, but I'll do some more scouting. Hopefully find some iron close by. Once I do find iron, I'm going to grab it all, as much as my ship will allow me to carry. And hope you liked seeing the automation of my base. I'll go ahead and get those mods that we were using last time and the scripts so that we can automate, you know, storage. Oop, just ran into a tree right through it. Automate storage and crafting and automate our refineries, that kind of stuff. If you want to see how to do that, just go check out my season one, like third video or something when I set that up. Maybe it's the fourth video. Cool. Well, guys, thanks for watching. If you did like it, make sure you hit the like button. It's really important to help my channel grow. Subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll hope to see you in the next episode of Let's Play Space Engineers. Catch you later. Bye.